Do you remember when Ken Ham and Bill Nye threw down over evolution versus creationism in a debate in 2014? Well, it's happening again. At the beginning of this all, in 2014, Ken Ham, who is a known creationism proponent, he's pretty much a fundamentalist.
Mm-hmm. I think self-proclaimed as well.
Self-proclaimed fundamentalist, yeah. Who operates the Creation Museum just outside of Cincinnati. He needed funding for the museum to happen at the time, and, you know,
trying like a bond, selling bonds, like war bonds meets Kickstarter.
Essentially Kickstarter,
yeah.
Which if you don't meet it, everybody gets their money back. That happened on in June of 2014. And so Bill Nye decided he would debate him. He didn't think it would get much traction, and it did, and it ended up somehow pushing the money needed over the limit. And that the museum was able to be built, though Bill Nye does say, oh, a lot of it has to do with the tourism for the state, the governor.
They sued, right? That they had to get a federal judge.
It
they
worked all together.
They didn't want to allow it because it's a religious thing.
Yeah.
So they said, well, it shouldn't receive public funding.
Well,
they
Nye said the new governor, the tourism cabinet he appointed, and the federal judge are all like-minded. They believe in the project. They would come up with something to make it go through.
So yeah, whatever it was,
so
it was
basically
gonna happen.
It was built, yeah. And now there's an ark, a replica of Noah's Ark.
Not the good kind of ark, as in the last one.
Don't
look into it.
Of the covenant.
Well, you still shouldn't probably look into this
at
one
all.
Either.
Well, I mean, Bill Nye did. He's a brave man, and he looked at this ark.
He walked all
and,
up in it.
He didn't. He wasn't impressed. he had a few choice things to say. His takeaway was that the kids are being brainwashed. I wanted to see how successful this thing is or could be, and I wanted to see the children reacting to it. This guy promotes so very strongly that climate change is not a serious problem, and that humans are not causing it, that some deity will see to it that everything is okay. And they've been going back and forth on it. Ken Ham posted to his followers on Facebook, basically, he challenged me on the content of our exhibits. I challenged him. It was a clash of worldviews. He asked if he could pray near Bill Nye. Bill Nye says, I can't stop you. Do whatever the hell you want. And then he prayed for Bill Nye in front of Bill Nye. And he said,
this makes me so angry.
Ham wrote, I asked him if we could be friends, but he said we could be acquaintances with mutual respect, but not friends.
Here's the thing. Here's my one take on it. I am not a religious person, but I have in my studies in school and university, something like that. And if he's saying that global warming is not a cause of humanity, mm-hmm. Well, the original flood, which history throughout all cultures, there was a flood because ice caps and it's the natural thing, whether or not who caused it, whatever, fine. But in their scriptures, it was caused because people weren't believing enough. There was things that need to be washed away, which means it was caused by humanity, which means a deity did not protect humanity. Ergo, what are you talking about? And also, you used cranes and $18 million to build this thing? And they're like, Noah did it in like 6 months. It's fine. humans built the pyramids. Humans can build great things.
Bill Nye there's those
polluting
replica cranes they had at the time.
Yeah. The forklifts. It was like, yes. Babylonian forklifts. I've heard of such things.
Yeah, I mean, Bill Nye has become, he does describe himself as agnostic.
Yeah.
But he has become the kind of the face of saying, no, climate change, man-made climate change is a real thing. We should be paying attention to it. We should stop invalidating it. So this has become his cause. So going head-to-head with someone who has, you know, the opposite cause, which is by and large loathed by scientists, it's become very exciting. I mean, I remember watching this debate back in 2014 and being enraged. Go back in my Twitter. I was just live tweeting it. I was so angry because you can't have a logical debate with someone who completely refuses to abide by logic or respect it. It just evolved into a mess. It made a lot of people mad, and I'm one of them. But yeah, now we have,
and even a lot of other religious organizations are like, look, we may teach these to our followers and stuff, but this is how you kind of get these radicals, way too strong a word, but even fundamentalist, of making it this, I think, over-exaggerated thing where they go, well, everyone believes this now, and it's now a thing that everyone should come see, and mm-hmm. I'm going to charge everyone to do this. I've gotten all these different organizations to give money, and then I love Bill Nye saying, basically,
oh, this sucks.
This sucks, and it's, here's the thing. Even if you look at it from an educational standpoint, the exhibits are poorly made. There's, like, it's just really poorly constructed.
He said it looks half done.
It's half done. There's no landscaping. It's just, like, he's like, even if this is what I believed, I wouldn't support this because it's not done well. It's big. It's a big piece of wood. But there's not much more to it. And he goes, yeah, it probably won't last the year. It'll probably fold.
I mean,
we'll see. Oh, damn, Bill Nye.
Maybe there will be a flood and the ark will work.
But it won't because it's attached to a building. They didn't even build the ark well.
I guess
I'm a stickler for mechanics and they didn't even build the boat well.
Yeah.
I loved that story, you know, just hearing about mythology and different stories and stuff from different cultures and things. And that's a great story. But if you're going to do it right.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe like a Lido deck.
Build it right.
Shuffleboards.
Just build it right.
I don't know. Just make it something for everybody.
I also doubt that would carry as many animals that it was said to have carried.
And what about the dinosaurs?
What about them?
Where are they going to fit?
They and the unicorns got left off.
That's right. They refused to bow.
That's how it works.
Bill
Nye went on to take selfies with the children and tell them the age of Earth has nothing to do with religion. And that I feel like he needs to stop giving Ken Ham attention.
Yes.
I mean, on one hand, he's like, oh, this is wrong, this is wrong. On the other hand, it's kind of it's literally feeding them money. So I don't know where to go on this, Bill Nye. You're so well-intentioned, and I like you so much. Audience, what do you think? Of the Ark in the museum, but more likely, Bill Nye versus Ken Ham. Let us know below in the comments, and please like and subscribe for more.